us pray for peace in our land. Keep our hearts from sorrows and pain. Bless us all with joy and hope. Love and care for each one in this world.
非常的开心啊，我们又可以迎来我们 Sister 许哲，那在半年的时间能够两次在中心能够见到 Sister， 我们感到非常的高兴，也中心所有的领导以及所有的上上下下都非常的感恩和感动。那我记得上次 Sister 来的时候呢，我们在外面去迎接的时候啊，我一看到他出现的时候呢，我们的眼泪啊，好几位同仁的眼泪就忍不住就流了下来。那我感受到是一种感动的一种泪水，是一种惭愧的一种泪水，是一种可以净化心灵的一种泪水。因为一个人的无私去助人的那种大爱，那种慈悲啊，他是在无形之中啊，就可以感染人，可以感动人，可以感化人，所以我们就会立刻就产生了一种很惭愧，很想起而效法的心啊。所以在这么美好的一个夜晚啊，我们今天呢又一次的能够去聆听 Sister 的分享啊，我觉得非常非常的荣幸。那今天晚上呢，我们是安排了一个访谈，由我们中心的諮商会的理事，也是中心教务处的处长宋宝兰老师呢，会跟我们的 Sister 许哲一起来做一个访谈。那我相信在这样一个访谈过程中啊，我记得上一次分享的时候，给我们印象非常深的就是，有朋友问为什么Sister 可以这么年轻，永远保持不老。那然后给我们印象最深的就是说了三个字，哈哈哈，也就是说非常开心的这样子哈哈哈，虽然很简单，但是告诉我们很多内涵，很多人生的一些真理。所以希望接下来的访谈呢，我们能够从中啊，也都对我们的人生有很多的启发。那接下来 ，Let's welcome Sister Teresa and Brother Rawong are complete by Teacher Song。把我们掌声欢迎宋老师以及吴许哲女士，还有他的及弟刘忠义先生，我们上台，有请。接下来我把麦克风交给我们的主持人宋老师，大家请坐。
尊敬的蔡老师，尊敬的李悦老师、理事长，还有各位嘉宾、各位同仁以及分会场的同仁们，大家晚上好。今天晚上呢，我们大家呢，有此这么好的机会啊，跟许哲 Sister 许哲，那为什么我们一直会称呼他 Sister 许哲呢？先告诉大家哈，我曾经问 Sister 许哲，那我可以称呼你老奶奶吗？许哲老奶奶吗？他说我不老，别称我老奶奶。这个很有意思哈，他说我还很年轻，所以呢，我们就决定了，就称呼他说 sister。那么这个 sister 是什么意思呢？哈 ，sister 我觉得是有两个意思在这儿。sister 许在40多岁的时候呢，到英国学习护士。当时呢，他学了护士之后呢，就被医院呢派了去管一个这个医护房。So she was in charge of a ward. So for anybody who's in charge of the ward, she's known as a sister. 就是说，如果任何人呢是那个看护长的话呢，就会被称为这 sister。所以是这个意思。她并不是修女啊，这个也是sister 需希望我们呢跟大家解释一下的。还有呢，就是她是视诸父如视父，视诸兄如视兄。Sister 的另外一个意思呢，就是姐妹的意思，就是她是大家的姐妹，好，所以呢，她觉得这个称呼挺好，所以呢，我们都称呼她为 Sister 许哲。那在我们还没有开始之前呢，我首先呢要在这里呢先放一个短片，这个短片呢是许女士啊，10月的时候。参观了他自己的故乡汕头，经过了这么多年了，差不多有八十多年，不止哈、哦，不止了。哦 ，Brother Rao 跟我说，差不多100年没回去了哈、哦。这次老人家在今年十月回到汕头。好，我们大家来跟大家分享一下我们 Sister 许的喜悦，有请。
2010年10月28日，阔别了96年、年长113岁的许哲居士，在助手刘忠义的陪同下，第一次重返故土汕头。1898年，许哲居士出生在汕头确实一个贫穷的家庭里。在他16岁时，随着母亲先后流浪到香港以及马来西亚的槟城。二战之后，47岁的他立志成为一名护士，志愿帮助落难的家庭。而后的岁月里，许哲居士定居新加坡，致力于社会公益事业，并在人生的晚年创办了老人院。在他看来，做善事是人的一种本能，就像有人渴了，很自然的你就会给他一杯水。
我照顾人呢，照顾不见地界，还是见地不见好了，顺顺搞不自己去，我再做多去见个人去就可以了，再个人去问候一下。我照顾那就是不见地不照顾一个，又该是不见地了，而且老人不。
第一次重返故乡，在当地官员的陪同下，许哲回到了自己童年生活过的地方汕头确实。这里有老人许多童年的记忆，当他回到小时候经常去的杨梅林旧址时，眼前物是人非的环境使他感到陌生而又亲切。
我手电视就不见了，我跟龙一起说就得不当。
But how do you feel? How do you feel? The difference?
I feel lost.
No, you tell them in your tune.
了，我这不要紧了啦。我的双头骨就拢算是刷个旧路，我上次就不无路个，拢算是刷不旧下，我挺爱。
嗯 ，You feel happy
啊 ？You feel happy to be here？
Of course。
你打着招呼。
十分欢喜。
哦。
哈哈笑。
之后，许哲又来到了当年生活的旧居遗址。被称为小确实的这里，100多年前是一个原始的聚居点，农民在这里自给自足，生活安稳。
哎呀喂，
哎
哎哎呀，
我妹呀，喂喂山头，
喂喂山头，妹呀。
在确实逗留了一段时间后，30日晚上，在汕头大学师生的邀请下，老人马不停蹄地来到了汕头大学新闻学院，并与部分师生进行了交流。面对师生们热情的追问，老人分享了自己长寿的心得。乐观幽默的老人充满智慧的回答引来了阵阵掌声。
I eat a raw egg. After eating the raw egg, I put my finger to clean out all the sticks to the sticks to the inside of the shell. And...
他还现场起兴高歌了一曲100多年前的童谣。在交流会接近尾声的时候，有人问他如何保持年轻快乐，并让许哲对大学生说一句话，他是这样回答的。好，谢谢。
刚才我们看到老人家一百多年哈没回到家乡，对家乡还是非常的怀念。那老人家的右耳朵呢，几乎已经是完全失聪了，现在只有左耳朵呢，大概还有20%到30%的哈，所以他的一个非常好的这个工作的伙伴，以及他算是他的 brother。就是他的弟弟，他总是说这是我的弟弟。我先介绍一下刘忠义先生。啊，这 sister 旭去哪里啊？都是brother Rao 哈、啊、在跟着，在非常细心的照顾着哈、啊。那今晚呢我们两个会合作，今天中午我们谈了相当多。那我基本上是用中文哈、啊、交叉这个英文。他就会跟我呢，用英文在徐女士的耳朵啊，帮我这个传话。因为呢，徐女士非常熟悉她的音声，而且她声音很大。徐女士，好，那今天呢，她也会用一个麦哈。
So you speak, son. You say yes.
Is it on?
Yes, it is on. Loud and clear. Welcome.
What do I say?
Welcome, then.
In English?
Yes, in English.
Welcome, everybody.
Welcome. 欢迎大家到来。
有。What do you want me to say? What secret?
您要我说什么哈？尽量提出，那我就先说了哈。Okay, I'll start.
Yes,
sister.
Start.
Okay, I'll start. Okay.
She will start.
Okay.
She will ask.
I
Yes, I will.
Very, very impressive.
You can count.
Yeah,
Very impressive resumes. Very impressive experience. 许哲女士呢，在1930年代就在香港
Thank you.
开始这个慈善的事业 ，right from the in the 30s.
Yes.
So, 那我们想知道说当年在三十年代徐女士为什么会放弃她那个高薪很高的薪水而成为一个义工呢那我想徐女士跟我们大家分享一下 What we'd like to know is what inspired Sister Xu to give up her high paying job and join the volunteer work and never ever to get a cent from her work again
Yes, so they want to know from youWhat moved you to do this voluntary work? You gave up your work with a German journalist company, newspaper company. So you gave up that work and you went forward to do welfare work. So narrate to us.
I gave up my work because it was earning money. I don't want money.I want to care for those who cannot pay, those who are hungry and cannot get food. That was my main idea, was to care for those who cannot pay. So this, I have started that since 1923. Till now, I look for people who need my care and cannot pay. I don't want payment.
我不需要钱，我不需要薪水，我需要的是为那些穷困的、需要我的人服务。我并不需要钱，我需要的是跟这些没有办法给我钱的人服务。
You can, you can share with them the story,
yeah.
Where you were in Shanghai and you saw a lot of poor people. You were in the.In the hotel.
Yes, I was in Shanghai. I was invited by some friends to a very posh hotel. We had a very delicious food meal. And when I left them, I came out the hotel. There was a man very hungry, very thin.Very dirty in the nails and the whole person was there looking. He had not eaten for many days. And that pricked me in my heart that what am I doing inside there? Eating a glorious meal. And this man, he's a man, he's my brother. He has not eaten for many days. So I told myself, he may notever, ever eat a glorious meal while any of my brother or sister remains hungry. So from that time, I devoted my life to care for those who are hungry and cannot pay. So I am a cheap beggar. I beg money from people and I feed the poor with it. So I'm a cheap beggar.
当时是二十年代的上海，我有一晚呢，就朋友请我去一个非常豪华的餐馆吃饭。那一顿饭呢，吃得非常的丰富，还有一些那个醇香的这个葡萄酒。那我们吃完了这顿饭之后呢，我们就出来，我突然看到一个男人。这个男人呢，穿的衣衫褴褛，很饿，非常穷的样子。当时呢，我立刻就升起非常惭愧的心。我当时呢，发了一个这么的愿：如果世界上还有一个像这么穷的我的兄弟在这个世界上的话，我不会再吃一顿丰盛的饭。所以呢，我往后啊，我像一个乞丐去讨钱。讨钱为什么呢？讨钱是为了我能够帮助像这一个这么穷困的兄弟。我是一个乞丐头。 So that's how you started the journey.
That's how you started your journey. From there,
I'm still a beggar.
我还是个乞丐，我还是在向大家讨钱啊。好，那么 Sister Teresa 去过好多个国家，包括这个巴拉圭。在第二次世界大战呢，也自愿的为那些受伤的这些士兵啊服务啊，为他们治疗。他也为他的弟弟啊，在怡保，大家可能不知道哈，在怡保呢开了几间这个养老院，还有一些收容年轻的这些女孩子。没人要的这些孤儿，所以 Sister Teresa 其实跟家人呢，她的特别是她的母亲对她的影响非常的大。我想 Sister 跟我们分享一下她母亲所教导的，因为她时常跟我们说啊，她从她母亲身上呢学了很多东西。比如说有一次 Brother Rao 可能我们就想知道一下，关于有一次他们在吃着这个番薯，番薯是我们南洋讲的地瓜。哦，所以啊，我想这个故事是可以说是 Sister Teresa 第一次了解什么叫做布施。他说当时他可能不太了解，不过这一个他母亲这个举动呢，留下了给他一个非常深刻的印象。啊 ，Brother Rao，
I want you to share this story about your very dear and lovely mama. How your mother have inspired you and taught you many lessons. So they want you to share the story of how she was so loving and kind.
Yeah.
And the story of your sweet potato.
What is it, sweet potato?
Sweet potato, your whole pot. Yeah.
Yes, about my mother. We were very, very poor. But my mother was...in spite of our abject poverty, very good-hearted. So in the early days, we were very poor, and so we went around digging the ground to get out some sweet potato, bamboo shoots, and all this was our food. So we were very poor. So we sat down to a meal of this thing that we found out of the earth.Then as we sat down to eat our very, very humble food, a woman and her child came to in front of our where we were eating, and she said, we are very hungry. My child and I have not eaten for 2 days. My mother took the sweet potato.Right away, gave it to them, told us, we ate yesterday, they have not eaten yesterday, so they have first right to this little humble food. So we are very happy that my mother was so good-hearted, and from then we learned a lesson. Till now, I still remember whoever is more hungry than I have first right.To the food, the humble little food that I have. I'd rather go hungry because I ate the day before. Whoever hasn't eaten the day before have first right to that humble food.
We were very poor when we were young, very poor. 穷到怎么样呢？就靠着那些修女啊，就把这个地瓜，就是她说的番薯，那竹笋送到我们家去给我们吃。那有一天呢，我们四个孩子跟我母亲在一起吃几个番薯而已哈，也没有什么东西吃。那突然有一个女人啊，一个妇女就敲门，母亲呢就出去开门一看，这个妇人啊，她说。求求你，我跟我孩子两天没吃饭了，你能够给我一点吃的吗？然后母亲二话不说就跑进来，把我们那几条番薯
就拿出去给他们吃了。我那时候很不了解，这母亲啊，我们都很饿啊，这就是几条番薯，你怎么还给别人呢？那母亲跟他们说，孩子，我们昨天吃了，可是这一些孩子和他的母亲两天没吃了。两天没吃饭的人哈，比我们昨天吃了饭的人比较有权利吃饭，他们有优先权，要先让他们吃，然后他就拿去给他们吃了。所以我现在学到什么呢？就是我如果昨天吃了一顿饭，今天如果有人跟我说我两天没吃饭的话，那个人有优先权去吃这顿饭。我到了今天我还想着这个，不要让一个比我饿多一天的人吃饭，哪怕我没饭吃，我也得必须让他先吃。这是我从我母亲那边学到的。
People always ask her, who is the most inspiring person to you? And she always say, her mother.
People 常常问我，谁，我的生命当中呢，哪一个人是启发了我最多的？我都会跟他们说，我的母亲。
Your mother most inspiring person.
I think it was also because of her mother that she actually came back and take care of her.
Yes,
that she's very close to her mother. In fact,
Would
you like her to share that story?
Yes, you can tell them, share a little bit of the story of.You came back about the story that you were away for so many years.
Yeah.
And then your mother wrote a letter to say, poor people, they are everywhere. You continue the story.
Yes. I was away for 32 years looking after people who had not enough to eat. Then my mother one day wrote me a letter.Poor people, they are everywhere. Mother, there's only one. And I'm getting old. She was 82 years. Well, I would say she was 82 years young because I'm older than that. Anyway, she said, I'm 82 years old. You come back, look after me. So I came back after 32 years away. She was very happy, took me by the hand.She thought I was a little girl that left her so many years ago, took me by the hand, showed all her friends. My nickname is Little Dog. I was born in a dog year. My little dog has come back after 32 years, just as if I was a little girl who left. My little dog has come back. So she was very happy.That the little dog has come back after 32 years.
I was in the outside working for 32 years. After 32 years, one day I received a letter from my mother. The letter is like this. Child, there are many people who are poor. Mother, you only have one.母亲现在觉得不很舒服，你可以回来吗？就是因为这句话呢，徐女士就回去了，就把 Paraguay 的还有其他那个国外的这些义工的事业啊，就结束了，就立刻就飞回到她母亲的身边。她母亲见到这个女儿32年没见面的女儿，她非常的开心。而许哲女士呢，有一个乳名叫做小狗 ，little dog。
OK。
啊，为什么她会叫小狗呢？因为许女士在狗年出世的，所以她母亲都叫她小狗。她母亲一见到她呢，就拖着她的手到每一个邻居的家，跟人家说：“ 我的小狗回来了，我的小狗回来了。32年，我当时看母亲的眼神，母亲把我当成是那个小女孩，那个30多年前离开她那个小女孩。所以母亲一直到处跟别人说，我的小狗回来了，我的小狗回来了，你们知道吗？32年没见面了，我的小狗回来了。所以她非常的开心，终于见到了自己的女儿。
Now we can add a little bit more here. When she was in Singapore, her mother was with her, and there was a period she was matron of the home for the aged sick, where she took care of 250 old people and about 49 staff.
And their families.
And their families. Also, there was a period where her mother fell down. Mother fell down, broke her hip. And at that time, she was about 90 over years old.
92.
She remembered. 92. Right?
92.
So, because she was the matron of the home, she was able to take care of her. So you share the story then. Continue with the story, sister, about your mother. When 92, you took care, she fall down, you took care of her.
Yes, and I was looking after her. Every morning early, I would feed her first, wash her, and feed her first before I look after 250 patients and 49 workers. And then my mother said to me, "You are very good to me." I say, "I'm your daughter." And she complained to me, "I have a daughter who a nurse never came to see me." And the daughter was feeding her. She said, "Never came to see me." She remembers I've been away for 32 years. And that in her old age, she remembers a daughter who's a nurse had gone away for never came to see me, telling me that I never came to see her.
Unless you say something, but this person feeding you is good.
Yes, she says that the person who is feeding her, she said, "You're very good to me." Yeah, "You're very good to me." And she said, then the mother said, "I had a daughter, never came to see me." But she was in front, feeding her. So her memory was going a little at that time.
At 92 years.
At 92, yeah.
其实徐他回去了之后呢，他没有停下来，立刻呢，他就在一个养老院哈、哦，就是照顾了250个老人，还有49个员工及他们的家人，他每一天呢都是这么样的工作，没有停过。他母亲呢，有一天呢就跌倒。那跌倒呢？那时候呢，他就必须啊，天天呢都很细心的照顾他母亲。他母亲当时是92岁啊。他每一天早上呢，他会先喂他母亲呢吃那个早餐。那每一次他喂那个母亲吃早餐的时候呢，他母亲会说：“哎呀，你对我真好，你对我真好。”可是我有个女儿哦，是做护士的，在外面32年了，从来没有回来。从来没回过来。当时老人家可能有点记忆衰退了哈，所以他每一天都会跟他讲同样的东西。我有一个女儿，32年没回来了，你很好，你很好。好，那么徐女士一直都没有停过。We'd like to know what inspired her keep going.Keep going.
Okay, they want to know from you what really motivate and keep you going for all these years, nearly 100 years you've been doing all this kind of work. So what really motivate you?
Because I was very hungry once, I had to eat grass. Now I hope nobody need to eat grass. Don't eat grass.
经过了100年之后啊，徐女士还是在为穷困的、孤独的这些老人家啊，鳏寡孤独在服务。100年了，不容易哦。因为我们很多发心是一年，不是第一年发心就佛在眼前吗？第二年发心呢，佛在天边嘛。第三年发心呢，就烟消云散了哈。这老人家100年能够坚持下去，他的信念是什么？什么东西推动着他？他说，他说，我在很穷的时候啊，我穷得要吃草。我现在不希望再有任何一个人会像我一样需要吃草。这就是为什么我100年之后还在做的这件事情。
She is just saying that you had this very what do you call memorable experience of eating grass.
Yeah.
And so you felt that if it is within your power.
Yeah.
And as long as you are able to,
yes.
you will see that nobody needs to eat grass yes, and so, go through that yeah. experience.
Yes, so don't eat grass.
不要吃草，不是很好吃的。
好 so you can share with them, sister, really, apart from that episode, why is it that you keep doing day in, day out,You go to Paraguay, you go to Europe, you go to Vietnam, you go to Singapore, you go to Malaysia, you're always feeding the poor. Why is that?
But I'm blessed with good health for the first place. I will always remember it wasn't nice to eat grass, and I don't want anybody to need to eat grass.I prefer to earn money, give it to them so they can eat rice and kway teow and ice cream.
I 一百多年都这么干了、因为呢我真的不想呢任何人会吃草。我希望呢能够有钱呢就让他们有饭吃。有这个沙河粉吃，龟吊哈，就是我们这里在炒这个，这像果条哈，还有雪糕吃，啊，我希望他们能够有这三种东西吃，而不希望他们呢吃这个草。
Translating what you just said.
那我也听说过徐女士说，爱是我的信仰，良心是我的宗教。Now we have heard, Sister Teresa have said that.Love is my faith, and conscience is my religion. Please share with us.
Okay, they have heard that your that saying that love is your faith and conscience is your religion. Can you share with us what exactly it is that you're practicing?
Yes. Love and what?
Love and conscience. Conscience.
Yes. What I have felt is, in my own personal experience, if I love everybody with a clear conscience, they are all happy. So that proves from personal experience that unconditional loving kindness is the best.Everybody, if they are hungry, if you lovingly give them to eat, they are happy. If they have no place to sleep in, if you beg money and pay for rental, they are happy. So love, I have experienced that is the most welcome feeling. If you love everybody, they all ha ha ha.
我觉得呢，我用一个很平等的那个良心去爱每一个人。 这个爱是没有条件的付出，只要有人饿，我就会提供这个食物给他们，只要他们没地方住，我就想办法帮他们住一个地方给他住。那我的经验当中，我觉得这种没有条件的付出啊，会使到呢每一个人呢很开心，会使到他们呢每一个人的感觉啊都会分享我这一个哈哈哈的喜悦。
Sister would like to share with you a story that not so long ago some friends invited her to have teh tarik session. A kopitiam lah, kopitiam lim teh lah. So there was this middle-aged couple, and the wife was sitting there, had something very sad in her heart and bothering her lah. So she asked sister this question, and the question was, my husband, mother had a very miserable death. She was in the hospital and she had a lot of pain and problem, and the husband did not really care much about her. Go and gamble, puakiao, mai kuan. So she couldn't take it. She jumped from the window to her death.
From 13th floor.
From 13th floor.
And she died right away.
Okay, now you continue the story.
There was a story.
Oh, let her translate first, then we'll come back. What's the story, sister?
徐女士很可爱的嘛。
很可爱。
就是不久之前呢，有朋友请他们去吃拉茶。那这一对中年妇人呢，就来到Sister Xu 的这个旁边啊，就非常的悲伤。就问了他一个问题，就是他的那个家婆啊，因为就病了，病了就进去了这个医院啊，可是他的先生呢，就是家婆的儿子啊，就不管，好赌，那好赌呢就不去看他的母亲，这个母亲呢伤心，太伤心了。就从13楼跳下来。我们现在请徐女士继续这个故事。
So she jumped down from the 13th floor, and then it was cut short her life, she died. So what happened was, she was saying to us that there was a monk who told them that you should not visit your mother in the grave. The reason given was, if you go to the grave and visit your mother, very bad luck will come to you and your family members. So they heard this, very sad lah. So ask sister what to do. So sister, you continue.
Yeah,
she was sitting down there and she was listening, and then she says, I have a thought that come into my mind. So we all was waiting, listening. What's the thought? Okay, she will translate first. And then you share with them.
Okay, 那么这么一个悲惨的事情发生之后呢，他们冷夫妇啊都非常的伤心。那就本来打算呢去那个墓碑啊去扫墓。可是当时有一个出家人就跟他们说，哎，你们不要去啊，因为他这么这个嗔恚心这么重啊，自杀呢会对你们呢不利，会给你们带来不幸啊。许哲女士突然她说，哎，等一下，我有一个办法。好，我们现在就听听许女士的办法。
So you said, I have a thought. Just I have a thought. And then you said, so what did you say? Share with us.
I said, love is the strongest emotion. Love conquers all. Your mother said, I'm unhappy. I'll go with you to her grave. And we keep on singing, Mother, I love you, I love you, I love you. So they, when I went with them to the grave, and we sang, we love you, we love you. And they cried, and I cried, because love conquers everything. There's nothing, no emotion greater than love. So all of us practice love always.
爱是最强的感情，爱能够化解一切的恨。我，如果你们愿意的话呢，我们会跟着你们一起到你母亲的坟墓那边，然后呢，我们一起跟她说：“母亲，我爱你。”母亲，我爱你。我们是可以把母亲那个恨呐、化解掉的，因为什么呢？没有爱，没有任何的东西会比爱呢更坚强。爱能够化解一切。所以他们就真的是去了。过了之后呢，这对夫妇啊就非常的比较没那么伤心，而且呢觉得自己心头一个大石头啊，终于呢能够放了下来了，能够终于把这个这么多年这个困惑着他们的这个负担呢、把它释怀了。非常谢谢徐女士的无畏布施。
So thank you for this. Love conquers all.Because of that sharing that sister gave to the couple, they were so, so happy that they cried and they were so overjoyed. They felt that at last my mother can peacefully go and the process have a close, have a happy closure. So then they felt very at peace within themselves.
And so free to love their mother.
And free to love their mother. That's right.
They 终于找到了心中的那份宁静。从此呢，他们能够啊，再去爱母亲，而相信母亲呢，在九泉之下也能够原谅他们。所以呢，他们都很非常的开心。Brother Rao, do you mind if we ask sister to speak a few things in Chinese?
Yes, sure.
Okay.
Sister, they're going to ask you, and you share in Mandarin with them.
Oh. Because I'm going to ask another very touching story.
Okay.
About the old lady who fell down.
Okay.
Do you mind? Ask her to share the question.
In Mandarin.
Okay.
Sister, remember.
My Mandarin is not good, you help me.
Yeah, I help you, yeah.
她说我的中文不太好，你要帮我。
Okay. Remember in Mandarin, yeah? Remember you used to go and visit your old folks.
Yeah.
And there was an occasion where you walk along the corridor of the... Yeah.HDB flat.
Yeah.
And you saw a unit, a door with the door slightly open. It was dark. And then what happened? You share it in Mandarin.
You too, 一点点开的，里面有没有灯？我就开门，我进去，亮亮的灯，我看到一个老人睡在地下，很臭，味道很臭。
Smelly.
地下很脏的，因为他绿店坐在地下，小便大便都是在那边，没有的吃。我说婆婆，为什么你睡在地下？你说我六天以前跌倒不能起来，很臭。我说洗衣洗好的，洗好的给他，屋子也给他抹干净。我说我去地下去买东西给你吃，他说好。我去买东西给他吃，同时我打电话的医院。叫他护士叫他带他去医院的，因为他发烧。那护士的来了，婆婆带你去医院，我不去医院，去人家去医院就是去死的，我不要去。我说婆婆，外面Orchard Road 很多孩子唱歌。我们去看他们，听他们唱歌，好好好，我去了，他一定没有的吃好几天，很累啊，很累。我带他到医院去，不知道，去了，啊，谢谢。有的时候骗的是好的。到他的医院去，我一定给他洗得干干净净的。他们得给他睡在床上一个空床给他睡。那我说我回家，他说你不要离开我。我说那我走，不让我走。我是立刻的吃饭，我还没有吃，我去吃。你一定要回来，我说我一定回来，让我去吃稀饭这样。因为我很饿，肚子很饿，好好，我就去回家去。第二天七点多，因为他们九点才让人进来看病人，七点都不去了，我赶快去看他怎么样。去了，他的床空的，有着别的一个人，不是他的，我是我的朋友，我的护士。我的朋友在哪里？他拿一张纸给我看，他连点离开了，回家去了，到上面去了。我说好，我很高兴，不是因为他跑掉，因为他死的时候，大家照顾他，他干干净净的，我就很高兴，他死的情形很好的，有人家照顾他，干干净净。
So how old was she, sister?
She was how, 她106岁。我带她医院的时候，我说婆婆你几岁？她说106。我因为她老得乱了，我看着登记，要带她医院去，要拿她这里，当然是一定的。他真的是106岁嘞，也说得对。
所以 sister 说啊，有时候骗人呢也是有好的哈。
No, she always have a way with people and human relationship, human interaction.Yeah, many times I've noticed her, she managed to go around and solve their sadness. There's another story after she will share with you. Remember the story?
Yeah.
You share with them.
You tell.
就是Brother Rao 说哈，他觉得就是徐女士呢，她非常的善巧方便，她就是心很细，她会很容易体恤别人的苦。
She knows.
她完全呢懂得怎么样帮人家呢解决他们的内心的那种折腾。还有其实挺多的故事的。
So now you share with them again. This Madam Choy Lai Oi. You went to visit her.
is being English and Mandarin.
各位要听中文的还是英文的？哦、oh, ，in Chinese.
In Chinese. In 中文。
中文。
中文 ，Cantonese Mandarin. Mandarin.
他是用广东话跟华文一起讲。啊
有句
啊，丢酒，
丢酒
啊，丢酒。
潮州话行吗？
啊，好，潮州话，阿姐。
啊，我去寻你个老娘去到考了，我讲，你做阿娘考你考咩事？伊讲我食屎去，我无该当卖考，我考业绩，请一个有钱的哥囝，即请个请个。真有兴趣啊，拍照啊！伊也是甲我拍照，啊，就无想着得啦。
你无想着
啊？啊，无想着也欢喜欢喜，拍照啊，笑过，就挂起伊小听个啦。伊甲我笑过，就唔记得也得去。所以呢，哎呀，我为难，买单哦，你们考啊，而且当做朋友是。当伊唔记得伊个功课啦，那伊拍手无笑过，哎，我笑啊过伊笑笑啦，搞无笑过唔记得个。
我只听到拍手唱歌哦，听无。我会听无啦，你会 translate 有无？No, no.
Okay, a single. I translate lah. One day, we went to Madam Choi Lai Oi. She's about nearly 90 plus lah. And when we went to see her, she was crying. She was very depressed. She was very sad. And so sister asked Apo, "Lei dim kai ham a? Why do you cry?" And then she said, "My."
阿
祖
死咗。
阿祖死咗。阿祖 uncle, my uncle died, 死咗。So sister never say, 阿婆 I give you tissue paper, we cry together, 啊。She never comfort her directly. So instead, she distract her mental attention and focus.Take her to another space, and this space is like a little child. And the child sing children's song, kindergarten song. Yeah. So sister was singing Kung Fu song, kindergarten song. So she sing, and the apple piak, and sing, and clap. Then sister noticed that she forgot the uncle.
You're into singing.
She was into singing. Thank you.
刚才是用潮州话讲述了的一个故事，就是有一天呢，他去拜访这90多岁的老太太哈，就发觉这个老太太一直哭，他就问老太太怎么一回事儿，老太太说：“哎呀，我的叔叔啊过世了，我很伤心啊。”他就哭。可是徐女士没有说：“哎呀，你哭得这么伤心，我给你一些 tissue paper 哈，一些面纸，来我们一起哭吧。”一般上我们都会这样嘛，你发觉到我们一上台分享一哭，我们就很紧张，拿那个 tissue paper 一个面纸给人家擦。他说，许真女士并没有，她怎么样呢？她牵着这个老太太的手，然后呢，她说来，我们来唱歌，啊，我来唱一首歌给你们听，啊，给你听，你就跟我去唱歌哈。她唱那首歌呢，是一首广东歌，啊，是关于功夫的广东歌。是不是 fight 的功夫的问？他是用那广东歌，广东歌。待会我们请许哲跟我们唱那首广东歌哈。
广东歌，
大家唱。
啊，大家唱。
大家一起唱。好。
腾腾卷菊花。 就咪病我咪病，阿嫲叫我睇龙船，我唔睇睇鸡仔，鸡仔大足气咪咪得几多钱，咪得三千钱，金腰带银腰带，请阿婆婆做礼拜。
汉言这个是广东的童谣哦，非常可爱的，所以他这么唱啊唱啊，结果呢，他那个老太太也跟着他一起拍掌跟唱哈、啊、唱啊，又鸡仔又金银啦、啊、又拜龙啦、啊、又啊唔知做乜啦、啊，咁结果佢忘记咗佢叔咧已经往生咗。So I mean, the old lady was so happy that she forgot that her uncle passed away.就是他高兴到怎么样，他忘记他叔叔往生了，就又把这个老人家从忧伤当中呢带了出来。其实老人家活了这么久哈、哦，看了非常多的死亡，我想听听老人家对死亡的看法，以及对自己的亲人，特别是他的姐姐、妹妹和弟弟。在同一年，应该是1973年同一年相续的往生啊，相续的过世。我们想听听这个徐女士啊，她面对这些时候，因为她很多时候呢她必须帮人家开解啊这些问题。Sister Teresa, because of her age and so on, she has faced many deaths before. How does she overcome her griefs?Especially her brothers and sisters.
She's saying that you've gone through so many years of living.
Yeah.
And you're nearly 120 years
yeah.
now. Correct or not?
Forgot to die.
So they are saying, You have gone through so much in life.
Yeah.
And some of your loved ones, like your brother, your sister, your mother, well, who, they all are your loved ones.
Yeah.
They pass away.
Yeah.
Now, how do you feel? How do you take it? And share with us how you take it.
We believe that when they die, they go to an eternally glorious place.If they are in a better place, why should I be unhappy for them?
So I... Oh, sorry. Some of the people down there, they sit.
So, what does it mean?
中文啊, sister. They are asking you 中文啊.
Oh. 我说什么话?
Oh, sister.
我说什么话？
你说什么话？你说英文啊？
哦。What was the story?
That remember the mother, the loved one, the brother, the sister, they all pass away. So how do you take it? How do you deal with it?
那我的，我那我在读 Mandarin 哦、okay?。
Mandarin， 中文。
啊，是，我因为我妈妈是104岁了。他已经要回家，让他回去，因为我的姐姐、妹妹、弟弟全都已经跑上去了。我说，假如他要回去看他们，为什么我要难过？让他跟他们大家欢欢喜喜的在天上，虽然是没有。冰淇淋也是很好的地方。
很神秘。
刚才 Brother Rao 在问这个问题的时候啊，他说：“老人家，您活了很久了，活得其实太久了啊，100多岁了，像差不多都115岁了啊。”这个时候呢，许哲他说啊，我忘记死了。
他不告
I forgot to die. Okay.
Okay, we need to give the chance to the floor to ask.
Yes.
Question.
那现在呢，我们大家，我们已经听了这么多，我们台上的这个问答嘛，我相信呢，台下的哈也一定有很多问题。那我们现在让你们把你们的问题提出来。许哲女士是个非常有智慧的非常有智慧的老人家哈，她的有一些答案哦，是我们想都没想到的。比如有一次，卫生部和福利部的官员去参观他的老人院，就发觉到呢，那个老人院非常的干净。那有一个官员就跟他说啊，哇，这么干净的地方啊，我老的时候能够住在这里吗？他怎么说？怎么回答呢？徐女士回答说：“你愿不愿意自己老了？”又病又穷又没人亲人照顾。
Remember there was a person came and visited.
好，因为有很多人就说嘛，哎呀，你就是照顾这些人呐、啊，什么用啊，什么？你其实如果真的有人照顾他们的话，谁愿意哈、哦、被人家照顾嘛？所以那徐那个 sister 的一句话，就立刻那个卫生部的官员哎，立刻汗颜哈、哦。所以这么好的机会
，I said to him.I used to be very, very poor. No house to go to, no income, no children. When all the conditions, you are sure welcome. He said, no, no.
、yeah, you say in Mandarin, sister. They all want to hear in Mandarin.
What did they say?
You said in English.
Oh, 我有个人来我的老人院。说得很干净啊，大家看见大家阿弥陀佛，看见大家很高兴。他说我老的可以来这边吗？我的条件就是你没有儿子，没有亲戚，没有钱，没有屋子给你住，你肯吗？你的屋子丢掉，你的钱床丢掉，孩子大家亲戚床丢掉。你可不可你可我欢迎你不要了
丢掉
就是你愿意把你的财产全部丢掉孤苦伶仃的话我随时欢迎您过来住
好 better ask them questions so sit down there let them ask questions they will ask you questions 好吗好吗？他们问
好啊，人家问问
问问问问问问问问问问，有吗？有吗？啊，对对，是这，
好。
We give him the microphone.
It's not like ice cream cone. It's not like ice cream cone.
This is not an ice cream cone.
Respected 许哲女士，非常荣幸能够在马来西亚看到您。我是来自大陆云南省昆明市的，一所中学。然后我在我上的学校初中的教材大陆是叫思想政治，它上面为了教育青少年提到了一位诺贝尔和平奖获得者，就是特蕾莎修女。然后我在网络上看到许哲女士的报道，非常感动。我刚才想到提问，我就想到那个许哲女士有没有有这个希望获得诺贝尔和平奖？谢谢。
Yeah, yeah, translate to me, then I relay to her. Yeah.
Okay,
very long question. 很长的问题，对。
不过很有实质的哈。好，这个提问是说，这个是个中学的老师啊，是教那个政治思想的。那有一个 ，Oh yes。
English first, then she replied.
Then she not.
They're Mandarin because they know already.
Okay. Oh yeah. What language am I talking about?
It's a Mandarin question.
You see, I'm being influenced. Okay. He is a teacher, secondary school teacher, who teaches political thinking.
Teaches.
And then political thinking.
Political thinking.
Oh, yeah,
Mao Sheng. Mao Sheng.
Mao Sheng.
Mao Sheng. Mao Sheng. How do you say Mandarin? Mao Sheng.
Mao Sheng.
不是笑话。
啊，不是笑话。Political thinking.
Oh yes. Oh, no joke. 不是笑话的啊。
不是笑话。
Then they came across Mother Teresa.
Came across
the as a subject of Mother Teresa.
Subject of the Mother
Teresa being a Nobel Prize winner.
Not the Nobel Prize. Yeah.
Does Sister Teresa, will Sister Teresa be inspired to receive a Nobel Prize as well?
So he is asking you, would you be inspired to receive the Nobel Prize?
No. No. No, I don't want a prize.
In Mandarin, sister.
我不要个奖品，因为我奖品啊，人家说的很多话，我不要，我要静静的躲在我自己家里偷吃冰淇淋。
还有看书。老人家很喜欢看书。
Yes, but you just, they know already, huh? So, sister, no need Nobel Prize, huh?
No need.
不需要一个诺贝尔奖。他说我有空吗？我在家，很低调的，在休息啊，或者吃冰淇淋。不需要诺贝尔奖。
She is always very quiet, simple and humble. No fanfare, no fireworks, nothing of that sort. But a lot of other people around would like to give her a Nobel Prize. And recently, 2009, you have in Singapore the National Day Award. So,She was awarded the Public Service Star Award last year, 2009 in August. And the President of Singapore gave her the medal. But she does not worry at all about the stars. She worries about...The hungry brothers and sisters. Thank you.
Brother Rao Wu 说，这个八月啊，去年八月，新加坡政府颁了一个公共服务明星奖给徐女士。徐女士呢，其实对这些奖状呢一点都不觉得怎么样。他说最重要的就是我的挨饿的兄弟们能够有东西吃。Brother Rao, I have a question here.
Okay.
Sister, did you ever get angry over anything in your life?Did he ever, even once?
The question is on the floor.
Yes, on the floor.
Yeah.
Did you ever get angry ever once? If so, share with us the episode.
No episode. I was never angry. Everybody is good to me. And I go around and offer food to the hungry. They will eat the food, they won't make me angry.
Now in Chinese, in Mandarin.
Later we ask you to share that in Mandarin.
Yeah. What was the question?
Have you ever been angry? And if so, share with us. If not, share with us.
人家问我有没有生气过？我说我没什么坑穷人的，因为他们没有吃饭，我就拿东西给他吃，我拿东西给他吃，他不会骂我的。
Also, she has always said, my brothers and sisters, they love me. And because they love me, there is no way I can be angry with them.
就是他们都爱我，他怎么对我生气呢？没有机会生气。他们没有机会对我生气呢，所以我也从来也没有机会生气。因为我都爱他们。
She likes your answer.
Yes.
That she laughs.
Ah, ha. 好，下一个问题。
没有机会。
哎，我不要机会生气。
我不要有机会生气。No question.
Yes, question.
No more question. No more question.有一个问题想请教您，就是在您这漫漫的人生当中，有没有遇到过不顺心的事情，或者是挫折，或者是不顺利的时候，您是怎样对待的？谢谢。
Okay, the question was, did you ever encounter any difficulties?Or anything that you feel that is not going that smoothly in your life, and how did you overcome these feelings?
Okay, I'm asking you the question.
Yeah.
Have you ever in your life encountered difficulties? And when you do encounter it, how do you solve them? And how do you find solution to solve it? Share with us.
When I encounter difficulty, I solve it the best I can.Having done my best, I accept the rest and live with it.
Okay.
Okay.
Do you want
okay.
in Mandarin?
So they want you to share that in Mandarin.
我忘记了。
So you, when you encounter difficulties,you will solve it to the best you can.
I can't in Mandarin, can I say? 我不会说我不会说华语的，我不大好。
好哦。
Difficulty.
Now I'll
encounter difficulty. How do you you say you solve it to the best of your ability?
Yeah,
then,
but I can't say it in Mandarin.
Oh.
Don't I help?
So,
我就帮个忙。
She will help you.
好 I'll help. Okay. 徐女士非常谦虚，她说她的中文不太好。所以我们就帮个忙。这个问题就是，你有没有碰过不顺心的一些问题？那你碰到之后，你是怎么样去克服的？徐女士说也没什么，尽心尽力就好了，尽力就好了。You try our best.
The best thing is maybe to share with you.And experience, a life experience she encountered, which was a difficult situation, but the way she managed is out of this world. So she will share with you. In her old folks' home, she has 250 old people. And there are men's ward, women's ward, and they are ward 1 to ward 10. 250 old people and 49 workers. So there was an old man. This old man disturbed the whole of the peace of the ward. Right? So every time he go to the neighbor, he go and disturb them all, and they all cannot sleep. So she tried all methods. Here is the answer.
我就放他的床到那里去，就是老是打扰人的。以后呢，我就说，我带你一个房间，自己一个人，特别的，第一号的
hotel
啊啊，我带你去那边，这是死人的了，那个。那个房间是空的，没有人的。那么我大家知道的，死人死掉了，放在那边，等他的家人来接他回去。我说我空房第一号的，你不要付钱，我给你住在那边，自己一个人，第一号的，最好的，没有人打扰你的哦。我带他去。我要回去，我要回去。我说你这边很好吗？我不会收你的钱啊，你自己一个人一个大房间啊，没人打扰你，你也不会打扰人啊。他说我要回去，我要回去。我说你等明天看怎么样，你惯了你就很喜欢这个房间。我要回去，我要回去。是那假如我带你回去啊，你会跟以前的打扰人吗？我不会，不会，我不会，我很乖，我很乖。我说，假如你打扰人呢，第一分钟我就送你回来。好好好，我要回去，我要回去。带他回去啊，很乖，没有问题的，没有问题。Perfect cure.
It's a perfect cure. Not only did she cure the man, but he go and tell all the story to the neighbors, the old folk. Don't create trouble. You go to the first class hotel. No, no. And all the others got killed. They got frightened also.
很乖
、this is a place known as the mortuary room. In most of the old folks' home, they have a place when the patient dies, maybe in the early morning, nowhere, the family all didn't come and claim or whatever, they put it in the mortuary room. And then wait for the relative. If there are no relative, then the police will come.And do the burial on the rites. So she has a solution.
So there's a perfect cure.
Perfect cure. Perfect cure.
No more disturbance.
No, and peace. And
not only for him, but the others also. They don't make noise.
Oh. Mandarin is a Mandarin.
Also, 他以后他自己不会打扰人了，就是别的人看见他这样子的。我送他去死人的地方啊，别人也不敢吵了，不敢干扰干叫或者的
啊，干叫我读了，真的 ，they understand，
对、yeah, 很好。
就是有一次他们那个老院那边呢，就发生了一个老人家哦，常常去干扰别人，整个院都给他搞到天翻地覆的。那终于不行呢，这个许女士呢就说：“好，来，我带你去第一号酒店。”是骗人的啦，她说啊，不是真的哈、哦。原来去那个是什么地方呢？是放死尸的地方。然后她去到那边呢，她那个老人家说：“我要回去，我要回去。”许正女士说：“不会啊，这个很好啊，这个地方很好啊，我要回去，我要回去，我要回去。”说从此以后呢，她不再敢好骚扰别人，而且她还到处跟别人说。哦，你们哦，你们不要制造麻烦哦，要不然会去那个第一号房啊。从此以后呢，都没问题了哈、哦。
所以我们可以看到许哲女士的这个善巧方便，然后许哲女士虽然是这么勤俭哈，这么的惜福的为照顾穷人，她曾经说过，照顾穷人是我的责任。可是许女士的福报却越来越大。What I was saying, telling them is that even though no, she doesn't spend anything on herself, she keeps taking care of the poor people. Taking poor people is a responsibility, she once said. However, her fortune seems to be growing larger and bigger. Her fortune, her good luck, everything she thinks about will happen.
Keep increasing. Okay. Not at all.
Correct, yes.
No thought of rewards. No thought whatsoever of rewards.
就是许哲女士的布施呢，她是从来没有想过要有什么报酬的哈。她就是这么的付出，从来也没有想到有什么福报啊，还有福气。可是我们都知道，她心想事成。他没有油的时候呢，油会有人送过来；没有米的时候呢，有人会送米过来。他的福报越来越大。可是许女士刚才她说呢，她说我从来没有想过这个，我只觉得这是个责任，我应该做的，就是应该做的而已，从来没有想过我有什么报答，或者我有什么好的报应，我从来没有想过这个，这是我应该做的。
OK。
好，下一个问题。
还有问题啊？对对对 ，The lady。
好，那边。
Hello。This is the Teresa. I'm really touched by what your love, your.
Sorry, she is very touched by your love.
By your.Loving kindness for human, especially the poor and the abandoned. I just want to know, I'm also curious to know that what about your love towards animal? Are you a vegetarian? Thank you.
So she asking the question, she says that you give a lot of love, you love the poor, you love the hungry. How aboutyour love to the animals, and the question is related to non-killing of animals for your food. So are you a vegetarian? So can you share with us?
I am a perfect vegetarian. I never cause pain for my pleasure. I'm a total vegetarian.
刚才那个问题是我非常感动许女士您的这个大爱跟慈悲。请问许女士，您对动物的看法怎么？你是不是一位素食者？许女士说，我是个标准的素食者，从来没有伤害过任何的动物，我是一个100%的素食者。
You share with them, sister.You share with them that when you were very small, your mother's mother, your mama, grandmother, live in Kakchio, Swatow. Then you tell them in Mandarin.
我小的时候，我的婆婆她的儿子要住在靠近海，他们天天去抓鱼抓的里面的鱼啊，什么东西抓来吃。他就说你不吃鱼你不会赚， 我说我不敢吃鱼，因为你又杀鱼，你自己想哭，你又害得鱼很痛。我说我不要。
So they give it to you.
啊，他就吃，你不吃你不会赚。那我就吃一点点的，发红。那以后呢，他死掉我还在，我就跟大家说，我的婆婆吃鱼她死掉，我不吃鱼我还在。他说吃鱼不对的。
就是 you are stronger,
就是以前母亲逼他吃鱼嘛。
他
说你看你们都吃鱼，婆婆也吃鱼，可是婆婆去睡觉了，我还在。睡觉了就往生了。他说我可是我不吃鱼，我是素食的，你看我还在。
So does that answer your question? She loves vegetarian food, vegetables.
I cannot eat fish.Don't want to,
I cannot. She is a vegetarian, a complete vegetarian. No onion. No. She have an egg every morning. Sister, you share with them every morning.
Yeah.
In Mandarin.
No. I eat my egg myself.
share the goodness of this in Mandarin. You share with them the egg. Every morning, what you do?早上
每一天我睡醒了的吃一个生鸡蛋，吃好了里面的里面的
蛋白
的块
蛋白、
蛋白
啊
蛋白，
我就来
查自己的脸儿。
那一个人就告诉我你不能这样子做啊，你生鸡蛋有毒啊。我说我很喜欢读，那我用读来看着这边，我还没有死掉嘞。
She loves her egg. Every morning, she will have a raw egg, not cooked.So you crack it slowly, and then she will take a little bit at a time. And then when you finish the egg, the inside of the egg, she will massage the whole of the face. And that's why you see her face very smooth, no wrinkle. And it's the best cream, facial cream, from the egg. Thank you.
许哲女士的美容秘方哈，原来是鸡蛋白。她就吃完了那个生鸡蛋之后呢，就把这个壳里面剩下来的鸡蛋白啊涂到自己的脸上，这是她老人家的这个美容秘诀。这时间过得好快哈。
She says also, she knows that if you take the egg and you crack and peel off the skin and take the membrane off.She knows whether the egg is bad or not. How? She looks inside and makes sure the egg yolk is whole and not broken. If it is broken or for some reason the egg yolk is not whole, don't eat the raw egg. Thank you.
哦，这个重点哦，老人家嘱咐大家说，如果你把那个蛋呢敲破之后呢。就看到那个蛋黄是破的就不要吃，破的蛋黄呢就说这个蛋已经不好了，所以那个蛋这个生蛋的蛋黄要整粒才是好的，那个生的鸡蛋这是老人家非常的关心我们，要不然我们就学到赶快每一个明天早上吃生鸡蛋。
They are saying that tomorrow morning they are all eat raw egg. Good luck to you.
而且说祝福你们。好，时间过得很快 ，the time flies.
They say that time flies.
Yeah.
I'm sure we would love to ask more questions.
They say they would love to ask them more questions.
Yeah.
But
they say time flies.
Okay. We all fly home.
We all fly home. One more question if you have. No time. One last question.
Okay.
Is that right? Okay, sister.
Is that okay for one last question?
One last question.
我们最后一个问题。
Okay. Oh, if no question, then.
Okay.
Oh, you have many hands now.
Last question, 最后一个问题。
That one also behind.
Yeah.
Oh.
What? You first in that one.
Oh.
尊敬的许哲女士，您好。我是来自中国内蒙的一所希望小学的老师，我今天第一次听到这么让我感动的内容。我想请教的一个问题就是，如果像我想要学到您的这样的爱心，并且把这种爱心传递给我所即将面对的那些孩子们，您对于这样的一个老师，您最想教会我一些什么？您怎么来指点我，来教导我，学得像您一样。好，谢谢。
What did you say?
I just asked so many questions. Wait, who turned to answer? What did she ask?
She.
I'll translate it.
Translate
to you. Okay, I'm a teacher, okay, from a school of hope. Today I have heard a very inspiring speech and inspiring sharing
from you.
Sister, and I would like to ask sister, what can you tell me, teach me about how to convey the love to my students? How do I learn from you the unconditional love, the compassion to my children, to my students?
So she's asked, and she's inspired by your sharing session.
Yeah.
So she asked you whether how can she convey loving kindness, loving compassion to her student?
Practice it.
Say Mandarin.
你就这样子做了，就爱他们了，对吧？
very good.
你就这样，你就爱他们。
Love them.
不要骂他们。
Answers. She answer.
Yes, very good. 你就去做，去爱他，就爱他就对了。
Do.
不用说，就去做。
She's always action.
她是以行动为主的。
Action and practice.
要落实。
Now, 现在。
就是现在。好像后面还有两位哦，
立刻哈，
能够吗？好，来，我们主办的说还可以。
What happened? One more question. Oh yeah, one more question. All right. Yeah. Okay. Sister, they are warmed up and they want to ask.
Yes. Okay. Don't get too hot.
许哲女士您好。我要提的第一个问题是，您为什么这么喜欢冰淇淋？您的老人院的朋友都能吃到冰淇淋吗？第二个问题是，我们在大陆也在学您的这种精神，办公益的养老院。
One question at a time.
Say Mandarin, sister.Mandarin，
他说一个，先答你的一个问题。
你讲那么多，我不知道怎么
答应你。
答应你怎么答应你？
好，那我们
好的，谢谢。
回答你。
回答你。
好，那我 the first question。
第一个问题。
第一个问题。
Okay， why do you like ice cream so much？
Why do you love ice cream so much？In Mandarin, sister.
冰淇淋很好吃。十分好吃。
Okay.
我有不分一点给你吃的。
Okay, next.
Okay. Yes.
Second question.
第二个问题是，我们在大陆也在学您的这种精神，办公益的养老院，这个方面也需要，也请您给我们，最重要的经验介绍和指导，谢谢。
We also am trying to set up this free old folks home for the people in China. Can you give me a very important a reminder?
Okay, the brother says they are also trying to set up old folks home for free in China.
Oh, in China.
Yeah. Can you share with us, give us some advice? And yes.
你要做一个，你要做一个大大的老人院，那你就要有床给他们，睡觉。你同时要有人照顾他们，那这些就要准备好，就可以离开。哈哈哈
哈哈哈哈哈哈！哇！What did you say?
没有事能够难倒他哈。
买也好。
他说您就盖一个很大的老院。
Yeah. Get furniture, get people to help.Then start.
他说就很简单，您就盖一个很大的老人院，把床弄进去，找人来照顾他们，就可以开了。还有把这家私也弄进去，就可以开始养老。
Say Mandarin, start tomorrow.
明天开始。
各位会场上的朋友们以及分会场的朋友们，刚才这么风趣，可是又有这么有内涵，
okay.
来自一个年轻人。一个113岁的年轻人给了我们很多的这个启发，真的很想再谈下去哈。不过时间真的飞逝，徐女士说，既然时间飞逝的话，那我也要飞回去了。I'll fly home too. So, 那我们这里呢，世界没有不散的缘起哈，可是这绝对不是最终的。这是也是另外一个开始，所以我们在这里呢，我们首先要谢谢曲哲女士给我们这么有智慧的一个分享。我们也非常谢谢刘忠义先生 Brother Rao 今天晚上呢跟我们传话。And now we have a little souvenir presentation for Sister Teresa. And we would like to invite our director, Miss Alice Wong, to come up to the stage to present the award. Sister, we're going to give you an award. 我们现在邀请中兴的董事长黄秋云女士上台颁送纪念品。他们说非常谢谢大家。那我现在的今天晚上的节目呢，交回给大会的司仪，谢谢。
这么多的快乐，这么多的感动，那正是这样的一份爱心啊，让陪伴着很多人的人生产生了很大的一些变化，那给予了很多的人生命中很美丽的色彩。那非常非常的感谢，我们最后以最热烈的掌声再次感谢许哲女士以及刘玉丽先生。那在今晚交流会即将结束的时候了，我们邀请蔡老师为我们做总结发言，有请。
啊，尊敬的许哲女士，啊，刘先生，啊，尊敬的啊诸位贵宾，诸位长辈。啊，诸位朋友们，大家晚上好。俗话说得好啊，百闻不如一见。哦，我们真正呢，看到了一位智者，一位长者，他的人生呢，可以这么有意义。哦，而今天呢，我们也知道啊，许哲女士啊的一个重要的身份呢，叫丐帮帮主。大家要知道，我们在看武侠片的时候啊，在看武侠小说的时候啊，功夫最好的都是什么？丐帮帮主。哦，所以真的是名不虚传呢，他的人生智慧啊，给我们的启发太大太大了。而我们今天呢，能跟许哲女士相会啊，这是一个非常难得的缘分。啊，我们老祖宗讲呢，不讲始终啊，讲终始。啊，讲始终啊，就代表这个缘分结束了。讲终始啊，就代表这个缘分呢，啊，开始了。啊，为什么是开始了呢？因为我们珍惜了许哲女士给我们人生的智慧跟启发，所以她的这一份精神呢，啊，从此以后会活在我们每一个人的心中。啊，就像刚刚一位内蒙的老师，他问了一个非常好的问题。啊，我以后啊，怎么去爱我的学生？我相信许哲女士已经给她最好的回答，赶紧去爱，不要骂她，不要打她，好好的去爱她。而我们许哲女士她所创办的单位啊，就是心连心 Heart to Heart。 所以 好，所以今天许哲女士以她至诚的心呢，跟我们谈了这么多的人生的智慧，我相信啊，这一份心呢、啊，也已经传到我们每一个人的心中了。而我们祖先圣贤人呢、啊，他们在经典里面所留下来的教诲啊，都是他们人生当中真正做出来的。那个不是理论，那个是人真实的德行的流露。而许哲女士的一生呢，事实上都做到了我们儒道释三教圣人的教诲核心所在。比方儒家，孔曰成人，孟曰取义，最重要的就是仁义存心。而许哲女士从小甚至对动物都是仁慈的心，一直保持了一生呢、啊，对动物、对一切的生命、啊，尤其是对最苦难的人，他是竭尽全力的去帮助。当他看到苦难的人呢、啊，他绝对不袖手旁观呢、啊，叫见义勇为。而且我们在《论语》当中有讲到啊，夫子之道，忠恕而已矣呀。夫子的处世待人的核心啊，忠恕之道。我们看到忠字啊，尽心尽力。刚刚许哲女士的回答，你就尽心尽力去做就对了。好像我们复杂的人生呢、啊，在许哲女士的心中啊，一下子就解开了。所以啊，其实人生没有那么复杂，它是很简单的。我们别把它搞乱了，尽力就对了，岂能尽如人意啊，但求无愧我心呐、啊！所以许哲女士说到：“良心就是我的宗教啊，爱人就是我的信仰。”多么简单的人生态度！所以这样去处事啊，身心啊都是非常自在的。而我们孔子的理想啊，大同世界，大道之行也，天下为公。确实啊，许哲女士这一生没有为自己想过，念念都是啊为别人想。所以许哲女士说，生命是什么？生命就是爱，很简单呐、啊，却讲的非常的深刻，非常的明白。而且啊，讲信修睦，所以大同的教诲，每一个人都可以在自己的人生当中做到。人不独亲其亲，不独子其子，使老有所终，壮有所用，幼有所长，鳏寡孤独，废疾者皆有所养。大家都这么熟哈、哦！我看待会大家一起唱《礼运大同篇》，欢送我们许哲女士，大家说好不好？我们每个人都效法、啊，大同世界啊，并不遥远呐、啊！我们道家老子的教诲：上善若水。水善利万物而不争。道德经最后讲的，己以为人啊，己以与人己欲有，己以为人己欲多。你为越为别人想啊，你自己越多。刚刚许哲女士说的啊，她想要给人家盐，盐就来了啊，她想要给人家油，油就来了。那他是性德的流露啊，他的福报就很大。所以这个都是啊，由于布施爱人啊所感得的殊胜境界。这叫至诚感通啊。他所需要的只要是要去帮人的，马上啊东西啊就送过来了。而老子说的人生的三宝啊，一曰慈，二曰俭， 三月不敢为天下先。啊，一是仁慈。啊，许哲女士啊表演给我们看。二是勤俭。啊，许哲女士说到呢，她的衣服啊都是从垃圾桶里面捡出来的，她从来啊不多花钱。啊，她觉得呢，假如是去享受了，那就是花了她兄弟姐妹的钱。啊，所以整个宇宙啊是她的家，所有的人呢、啊、都是她的兄弟姐妹。哎，这个是慈啊，又是勤俭。第三呢、啊，不敢为天下先，就是非常的礼让谦让，不敢鞠躬。啊，新加坡人呢都奉他为国宝。啊，人家跟他说：“哦，你是国宝哦。”他说：“不是啊，我只是一个哈、哦、会扫地、喜欢工作的女人。”啊，你看多么朴实的言语。而从这位长者的这个身教，我们可以体会到，我们做什么事情值得我们傲慢呢？值得我们邀功呢？啊，他为天下这么多人奉献呢，他却一点邀功都没有，啊，而且他觉得那本来就是我应该做的事啊。啊，再来，从佛家来看，慈悲为啊，慈悲智慧啊，在刚刚啊我们许哲女士的谈话当中啊，我们体会啊都非常的深刻。哦，而佛家讲的不贪、不嗔、不痴啊，许哲女士说到啊，她从没有烦恼，没有悲伤。为什么？因为他从不向任何人求什么，因为他不求，所以就没有求不到的烦恼跟痛苦。哦，所以这一段话就把我们的烦恼解决掉了。哦，就不会得忧郁症哦，是吧？哦，许哲女士说：“我享受我的每一天，我享受我的每一刻。”去付出，去爱人，所以我没有悲伤。啊，这个话好简单哦。啊，希不希望自己的人生越来越轻松？希望哈，依教奉行就对了。哦，而且不嗔哦，不发脾气哦。哦，许哲女士说发脾气哦，三天都调整不过来哦。哦，三天是许哲女士说的哦，我们可能要一个礼拜也调不过来哦。哦，这样子太浪费我们自己的生命了哦。哦，而且生气伤肝哦，身有伤贻亲忧，生气的人是不孝哦。哦，我们修身啊，首先要从孝道啊，要从爱惜自己的身心啊开始做起。而我们佛家修行啊，最重要的呢，就是要破我执，就是要放下自私自利。就像《金刚经》上讲的，无我相，无人相，无众生相，无寿者相。无我相哦，从来不为自己想啊，无我相啊。无人相，无众生相啊，任何一个人都是他的兄弟姐妹，他没有分别，平等对待啊，这是无人相，无众生相。好，有一次新加坡的总理啊，啊，请许哲女士去吃饭，啊，结果呢，她穿的跟一般的衣服都一样，啊，人家就说你怎么不打扮一下，穿这样就去了，啊，她说我对穷人是这样，我对，总理是吧？是哦，我对总统啊也是一样的。哇，那是真正啊，这平等心啊现前。再来无受者相，他对生死啊放下了啊。他说呢，我不知道，我忘了死了。哦，活的每一天呢、啊，尽心尽力 为这个天下人去付出。所以我们感受到啊，儒道释这些圣贤人的教诲啊，不是理论哦，是每一个人都可以落实在自己的人生当中。所以我们也期许自己啊，今天之后都能把许哲女士的爱向我们身边的有缘的人啊传递开来。让许哲女士这一份爱心啊不断地传递到我们整个世界，让世界更和平，让我们的人类啊能真正享受到幸福安详的人生。好，谢谢大家。
好，感谢蔡老师的发言。那因为时间关系了，我们今天许哲女士的交流会了就到这里。那诚如老师刚才所说的，大道至简，就让我们去做吧，用这份爱，用这份感恩传递开来，带着这样的感动去落实在我们的生活当中去。好，最后我们以热烈的掌声恭送我们的稍等一下，好，
起来唱。
好，我们一起唱，
然后送。我们一起唱，然后送着许哲女士。送给你这首歌。
纤纤玉能将心修复，人不渡其亲，不渡知己知，是老有所终，壮有所用，幼有所长，观花不渡非己者，皆有所养，看有分其余地也不必藏于尽，领悟其不出一生也不必危机，是不谋利而不行，盗窃乱贼而不作，不为富而不避，是为大为公，宣贤与能将心修复，人不渡其亲，不渡知己知，是老有所终，壮有所用，幼有所长，观花不渡非己者，皆有所其余地也不必藏于尽，领悟出一付出一生也不必危机，是不谋利而不行，盗窃乱贼而不作，不为富而不避，是为大
是啊，给他
好的，好的，
谢谢啊，他要唱了。
好，我们今天的交流会呢，在这个欢乐感动当中呢圆满结束。我们现在要恭送我们的许哲女士以及刘忠义先生。好，再一次感谢大家。
From sorrow.